This is a video on limits as it applies to calculus, generally calculus 1. And let's get started. You have to press second alpha to get these letters in here, INDEX, and then alpha 8 close parentheses to get the numbers and close parentheses in here. And you press enter and we're into the program. You can scroll down to whatever you want. We're going to do limits right now. These are all in alphabetical order on my menu here. We're going to go down to limits and press enter. Here's the choices. You can compute the limit. You can do a definition of a limit. You can do a table of limits. You can prove that the limit is equal to L, which is the limit. And also you can find delta given epsilon. So let's do this one first. Number one, you can press the number before the entry, and we're going to find delta given epsilon. And so you have to press alpha before you can put anything in these boxes that come up in my programs. And we're going to try 2 times x minus 5 equals 1, and we're going to, as it approaches, x approaches 3, you have to put alpha again in 3, and the epsilon they give you, and this will be on your problems in a test or whatever, alpha is, let's say, 0.01. So I show you what you've entered here, 2x minus 5 equals 1, x as x goes to 3, and epsilon equals 0.01. Press enter, and you can have the choice of changing it or saying it's okay. And here's the formula, the first formula, f of x minus L is less than epsilon. And so the next thing would be absolute, 2x minus 6. Took the 1 and put it over here, computed it over here for 2x minus 6 equals 0, 1, and, or equals 0, that's absolute values, and 2 times x minus equals 0.01, and you keep writing this stuff down on your paper exactly as it says here, and this is the way most YouTube videos do the problem, or what I could find, and epsilon equals 0.00, or delta equals 0.005. Now we can go back to the new problem here, choose new problem or main menu or new problem, and we're going to compute the limit. We want to go number 2. Let's compute the limit. Put anything in here that you want within reason, I guess. Alpha again. Anytime you're doing divisions, you have to put parentheses in any problem. So we want to make sure we get the parentheses in there. And let's go x minus 2 parentheses divided by parentheses x squared minus x minus 2 close parentheses as x goes to alpha 2. Here's the problem you've entered, and you want to compute the limit, and you say it's okay. Now, at x equals 2, f of x equals 0, and therefore it doesn't exist, so you use the following to find the limit. You add 0.01 to every x in there, just to get a little bit away from the limit, and then compute it. And the limit is 0.3. If you want to go deeper, you can go 0.332. You can go 1/3. Some tests are like that. 1 over 3.1012. 83 over 250. So that's the limit of that problem. Generally, in problems, you have 0.3 you'd put down. Let's do another problem. Let's do a table of limits, number 4. And let's clear that out there and do another one. Alpha, close parentheses, x minus 2 and divided by x squared minus 4. As x approaches 2, we have to press alpha first, remember. Here again, there's the problem. Now you notice here it already did this when they gave you a problem. It already computed the what you're supposed to do. And so here's the table. And you do this, you put down 2.01, add it, and you take 0.01 off of 199. You take 0.1 off of 2 and add it to this, and etc. And you put this down. You can see that the limit is between 24.95 and 25. You can compute that exactly, but this is what they want to show you on papers. And let's go do another problem here. Prove that the limit, this is always fun. Prove that the limit is L, the limit. This is done in always calculus 1 and throws every student off. You're panicked because they're talking about epsilon and delta and the definition of it, which is quite complicated, and of course it's useless for the rest of calculus in your life. Let's put a problem in here. Alpha 3 times x plus 5 equals 35. As x approaches 10, you have to press alpha again to put the 10 in. And here's what your problem is. You're saying it's okay. Here's the formula, fx minus l equals less than epsilon again. And you do this exactly like it's written down here. 3x equals minus 30. It factors it, what you need to do, x minus 10. And therefore, epsilon is equal to x divided by 3, and absolute x minus 10 here. And E3 then becomes delta, and here's the actual proof. If 0 is less than absolute of x minus c, c is a constant, is less than delta, then 0 less than 1 x minus 10, and less than epsilon divided by 3, and here's the answer, is 3x plus 5 minus 35 is less than epsilon. So that's what you put on your paper and get 100% on that problem. Everystepcalculus.com, check it out, and check out the blogs too on it.